I can't believe that worked. Trooper, yo, today is Saturday. So I want to thank everybody for calling into my anchor station. I really enjoy getting the call-ins, listening to them, and then responding to some of them or trying to respond to some of them. I responded to this dude's question the other day, and then he sent me another question. The funny thing is, a lot of people ask me this question, so I thought I would answer it on the vlog. All right, so here's Igor's question.
Hey man, thanks for answering my question today. I really like this anchor stuff, it's pretty cool. If you had time, I just wanted to ask you one more question, and that is, how do you go about studying as far as poker is concerned?
So Igor, that's a good question. A lot of people ask me that question. I'm going to tell you how I study the game. It's one of the best ways to study poker, and it's absolutely free. Let me show you my morning routine. Morning, afternoon routine. So obviously the first thing we gotta do is spin for our free chips. 8,500. Oh, look at that, I'm ranked like 38,000 in the world. So I have 53,000 chips as you see at the top, and I'm gonna play a 10,000 chip buy-in spin and go tournament. The reason they call it spin and go is because there's a random spin to determine what the payout is of the tournament. So this one will be 20,000 chips. And then it's just a three-player sit and go. I raise, they fold, I win. Pretty simple. And as you see, you just drag up on your bet size and it goes up and down. And then you pull it into the middle of the table to make your bet. Oh, look at that. I win. So if you want to play Jackpot Poker by PokerStars, there's a link in the description of this video where you can download it. It's free. And thank you to Jackpot Poker for sponsoring this vlog. That's right, you see it. Rain, also known as automatic happiness for the trooper. Feel like I'm in a an Excalibur kind of mood. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. You're at the Mirage. You're right. I had to stop over here because Pete and Allison from the UK, who I met last week when I was walking through the Link of all places, decided to do something completely unnecessary and leave a Starbucks card for me at the Starbucks at the Forum Shops, if you can believe that. I hope it's there. That was really unnecessary, but thank you, Pete and Allison. Let's hope it's there.
Thanks for doing that, alright. Thank you.
I can't believe that worked. Pete and Allison, are you crazy? What if, I was only about, I was 50-50 on whether this would even be there. Or if they would know what the hell I was talking about, but it worked pretty easily, believe it or not. Thank you. So the plan was to go over to Excalibur. Should I stick with the plan, or should I just stay here? Or maybe play somewhere else around here? Like maybe Caesars, or Harrah's. You know, I walk through casinos every day, almost. And it's so weird because day after day when I walk through casinos, I'm just living my life today. In 2017, but there was a time when I was just like 99% of all these people around us right now, tourists, if I was in Vegas or in a casino at all. There's a certain level of excitement that comes along with being a tourist in a casino. You know, it's not just the anticipation of gambling and all the excitement of that, but all the sights and sounds and smells of Las Vegas and casinos, it's really an assault on the senses. So it's a weird thing for me because I have been, as a matter of fact, if you go back and look at the videos just before I moved here from Jacksonville, you'll actually hear me talk about all of the sights and the smells and all the stimulation that comes from being here, right? But it's so weird because I've been really desensitized to all of it. But every once in a while, when I'm walking through the casino, just if I'm in the right kind of mood, I see the tourists, I see their excitement, and it can take me back to what it was like to go to Vegas or anywhere where there were casinos. The excitement that it, you know what I mean? Like, ugh, I kind of miss it. I'm here every day. I see slot machines and hear those sounds and all that stuff every day. It's actually a little sad. I'm envious of the tourist. Look at all this view action we got up on top of the Excalibur parking garage. I just realized I forgot my damn water and I'm about to freaking thirst to death right now. We got some Mandalay Bay action, some Luxor action, Excalibur. Got a view of the Troopermobile right here. Got some T-Mobile Arena action, some New York, New York. Little bit of MGM signature shits. All kinds of stuff. I know what you're thinking, Trooper, how you parked in the handicap spot? Bitch, I'm not in the handicap spot. It's not handicap on this side, it's just this side. It's funny because when I went, there's some view of the Troopermobile. I already knew at least 17 people were going to say, Trooper parked in a handicap, blah, 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 blah. How you doing? All right. Got a little Excalibur pool action too. How both elevators come and open. I don't know which one to pick. Shit. Looks like I picked the wrong. Oh, here we go. Damn. Usually smells like full-blown baby shit out here. Not today. Actually smells kind of lovely today. So I've taken a few days off from poker and vlogging, and I have sort of recharged my motivation to play but I've been pretty unmotivated to play. I've actually been having some crazy thoughts of doing crazy things.
By the way, there's the poker room. There's the Starbucks.
Pretty convenient location, if you're the trooper, for there to be a Starbucks, especially when I have $55 in comps. This is 460. For a proper coffee break, I do want to give a shout out to Adam and Emma and Emma's mom from London. Adam and Emma have been watching the vlogs for a long time. I just met them here at Excalibur. And yeah, congratulations. They just got engaged. Can you believe that? In Vegas, they got engaged. So, congratulations.
So this dude is having car trouble of some sort. I don't know if he hit the car in front of him or what, but he has his hazards on, which should be good, but he's decided to stand out there and wave traffic. I don't think that's very smart. I think let the hazards do their job.
So it's 85 degrees and we got some breeze action going. It feels nice out here, really nice. So it may be this way in other cities too, but the way it is here in Vegas, I don't know about everywhere else. But what I know about here, I don't know if that's a wreck or not, but here, if there's an accident and no one is hurt, the police don't respond. You're supposed to pull over, get your shit out of the way, exchange information, and handle it yourself. That is, of course, as long as your cars are drivable. Game was all right for a while. So when I left, I won $20, exactly $20, which is a little bit shit. I know that when fucking up the audio. Yo, shout out to the dude I just ran into over here when I was coming in the door. Dude was like, "Go gamble, what is that? Is that a brand?" And I was like, "Yeah, that's my brand." So I gave him a card and we were talking about it, and he's trying to start his own t-shirt shop too and whatever. And good luck, that's all. Go after the shit. Go gamble. That's what it's all about. Looks like we got some more rain action going out here. Yo, I gotta tell you, starting trooper wear and coming up with this go gamble thing has really, really got me super inspired. But it's got me inspired to maybe do some crazy things. And I don't know, maybe I need to do some crazy things. Maybe I need to go gamble myself. Maybe I need to take my own slogan and take that shit a little more extreme. You know, definitely reignited a fire that I had when I was a kid to sell shit and to be in business for myself and to just hustle and do business. I don't know why I ever stopped. Something happened though that maybe I don't even know what it is, but something had to happen to make me stop. But I definitely get inspired when total strangers stop me and they're like, "Yo, what's Go Gamble? Is that a brand?" I mean, I'm aware of what it is, you know what I mean? I have, it's obviously not the next Just Do It, right? And I don't have any aspirations of being the next Just Do It. I guess I'm just saying that if we look back and we look at my story, the story that is this vlog, and we look at what it has really been all along, it's been about me coming here to Vegas to build something out of nothing, right? It's, yeah, I play poker. I've been playing poker on and off for a long time.
You know, sometimes professionally, sometimes semi-professionally, I feel like the story is taking another turn. And, you know, I don't know. I'm just going to wake up tomorrow and do my thing, and we're going to see where it leads. But yeah.